Hi guys, CodeTutor here and my name is Anil Deshpande.
Welcome to the discussion of new topic, that is web services integration in Android. Some people also refer to them as web APIs or APIs. So when you hear this term web services, I'm sure some of the questions that you might be asking yourself are, what are web services? Why do we need them? How do they work? And what do you mean by integration of web services in an Android app? And this is what we will be discussing in this complete whole series of web service integration in Android. To basically understand what are web services, let's assume that you have two electronic devices and they want to communicate with one another over World Wide Web. To do that, you basically use web services. Some of the examples could be using a Google Home to communicate with Google, or using Amazon Echo to communicate with Alexa, or it could be a bank and a mobile banking application which want to communicate with one another. And it could be a bank with another bank that wants to communicate with one another to basically do any kind of banking transaction. In today's world, if you are hooked to World Wide Web, you cannot function without the concept of web services. They are being used pretty much everywhere. Now the question is, how do they work? If you have heard some of these terms like HTTP, HTTPS, SOAP, RESTful web services, XML and JSON, you are basically talking about technologies which are in one way or the other way related to web services. In this particular series, we will not be talking about XML and SOAP because they are not used predominantly in mobile apps web service integration. Before I address what do I mean by integrating a web service in an Android app, let's have a look at a web service in action in an Android app. So let me open a Kindle app. If I click on the store button, you basically see a busy symbol and some data seems to be getting loaded. And you will see this kind of behavior every time in any of the app. Whenever the data seems to be not present in the app at that moment, it basically shows some kind of a busy symbol. And then after some time, the data seems to be appearing. It is nothing but the Kindle invoking a web service to fetch the data from the remote server, which might be a server that Amazon might have hosted on some cloud. And this is how a typical web service will look like in real action. But to understand and learn the web service integration, we cannot use a very complicated app. So what we will do is, we will revisit one of the earlier apps that we had developed in the earlier series. If you recall, in the discussion of SQLite databases and the content provider, we had actually created a SQLite database for an app. And it was basically a to-do list app where you were able to enter a to-do item and the place where you want to do that particular task and add it to a SQLite database. And then there were also scenarios where you could delete the to-do list task and even modify them. Now we will reuse that particular app, but with a difference that we will integrate it with web services. So you basically have a scenario where you have an Android app with UI, services, broadcast receiver and content provider, and you also have a database, which in a typical Android application, a SQLite database. And this SQLite database is probably wrapped around with some kind of data service layer, which all this UI, service, broadcast receiver or a content provider might be using to update the database. It could be a SQLite adapter that we have discussed in the earlier series. Now you can clearly see that the database is part of the mobile application. Now, what if I shift this database out of the app and keep it as a part of some remote server? Now, my data service needs to communicate with the server which has a remote database. And that is what main focus of our discussion will be in this series. That is writing a data service which can communicate with the remote server through web services. You might be wondering, what are the scenarios in which we would have web service integration in a mobile app? Well, whenever there is a need for centralized data access, you want to prevent the data loss, because if you delete the app and if the data is only on the app, that data is lost. It is better that it is kept at a remote server. And then you own multiple devices and you want to access your data from multiple devices, then it makes sense to keep this data over a centralized server rather than on the mobile device. And also keeping on-device memory footprint low is another requirement, because you just basically cannot keep all data data on the device, because data might be too huge and it is better to keep them in some enterprise level databases like Oracle or MySQL. SQLite is silly for that. And in some cases, you basically cannot do away with web services. You need a web service. You cannot expect a Uber to work without a web service. You cannot expect Gmail to work without a web service. Basically, scenarios where you don't want your app to work in a silo and want to interact with the external world, you need a web service. And as you can make out, clearly there is a server part with a database. So somebody needs to develop server-side component which will be communicating with our mobile application. This server-side development is called with different names. Some people refer to it as simple server-side development, or you might have heard terms like web service development or RESTful web service API development. But from our discussion perspective, server-side development is completely a black box. We will not really focus or even discuss how web service API development itself happens. We are mainly interested in how do we write our Android app which can communicate with this remote server which has exposed RESTful APIs, and the data format that is being used is JSON. And this is what we will be discussing in the whole series. So please look forward to it.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.